This is indeed a disturbing universe.
Hello, greetings, and welcome. Welcome to the Stereo 999 YouTube channel. I am your host, the artist formerly known as Stereo Steve. And right now I'm waiting for the plumber who's going to come by and take a look at my toilet that's not been flushing properly. And it got me to thinking, what are some songs, what are some records that have something or other to do with the toilet or the bathroom? So I thought I'd show you a few of those as the barrel of ideas gets scraped closer and closer to the bottom for my show this week. All right, so I just got this stack. I'm just going to go through them here. Okay, this is I Just Can't Stop It by The Beat, a.k.a. The English Beat. Of course, the copies pressed in England don't have to say that it's The English Beat. And this is the album that has their song, Mirror in the Bathroom. Okay, another one here. The Mamas and the Papas. And according to legend, original copies of it have a toilet visible where they're all in the bathtub. I don't think anybody's ever really seen an original copy of this with a toilet. I mean, if you have, let me know in the comments. I mean, there are reissues, but you know, you can see the little flushing mechanism. Yes. Good old ABC Dunhill. Okay. This is Invisible Hits by Robin Hitchcock and the Soft Boys, which he was nice enough to autograph that for me when he came by KUSF for an interview back in the day. But this album, Invisible Hits, has their song, Rock and Roll Toilet, at the beginning of side two. A great rockin' jam. Okay. Sometimes you might be spending a little more time than you want to rocking and rolling on the toilet when you have the constipation blues like Screamin' Jay Hawkins. But afterwards, as Red Fox says, you gotta wash your ass, dummy. And this is the Japanese punk band Ultra Bidet. God is God, puke is puke. Let us thank him for this nuke. Yeah, it is. It's on Alternative Tentacles. Okay. But the bathroom is not just for that. This is Checkered, which is Chubby Checker's psychedelic album. I've shown this before, and I've said before, I unironically love this record. This record totally rocks. But there's the song, Stoned in the Bathroom. I guess he twisted one up. She came in through the bathroom window, protected by a silver spoon, yeah. Let's see. Steppenwolf. Steppenwolf the Second. This might be Steppenwolf's best album, in my opinion. It's got Magic Carpet Ride. It's got a lot of great songs. It's got this kind of plumbing kind of theme here with this artwork on the back. But the last song on the first side, Don't Step on the Grass, Sam. They're talking to Uncle Sam about the marijuanas that took way too long to become legalized and still not in every state. See, it ends, the song ends with the toilet sound effect. That's why I mentioned that. And I almost forgot to mention Brownsville Station. Smoking in the boys' room. But here's an interesting thing. The Canadian pressings of the Steppenwolf albums were on the RCA label instead of the Dunhill label. Pretty cool, eh? All right, well, if we're going to talk about toilets, we got to pay some respect to the king of rock and roll, for whom a toilet was his launching pad to leave planet Earth, Elvis. And his final album, Moody Blue. And, you know, it's always been a rule of thumb with vinyl that colored vinyl pressings are worth more than black vinyl pressings. This is an exception. The majority of these are on blue vinyl. But if you find one on black vinyl or in a super rare instance, any other color besides blue, those are the rare ones. All right. Any other toilet or bathroom songs or records that I forgot to mention, let me know in the comments. That's it. Jive music gets the spiders going. He thinks he's Jerry Lewis, huh?
Right. Go, spider, go. Spider, be good.
You know, it's disingenuous, though. I don't think anybody would necessarily drop their instrument like that.
For real, when I was a kid, like maybe 4 years old, 5 years old, I had this really freaky dream with this eerie music running through it. And the music turned out to be the Perry Mason theme. It must have been on TV while I was asleep or something.
no, you can't leave yet. You gotta have a nice cup of tea with me.
Okay, so I was in the bathroom just now and looking at social media on my phone, and I learned that the movie REPO MAN opened on March 2nd, 1984. So this would be the anniversary of the emergence of one of my favorite movies. And you know, I was at a cafe a few years ago, and I was trying to have a conversation with somebody about something, and I mentioned that Repo Man was one of my favorite movies, and this bearded hipster just totally got on my case about, why is that your favorite movie? Your favorite movie should be something like The Godfather. But you know, if that douchebag really understood The Godfather, he would know not to fuck with an Italian when he's talking about his favorite movie. But anyway, I'm going to show my collection of Repo Man related swag just to, you know, take up some more space in this video. So this is my VHS, my VCR tape of Repo Man that I've had ever since the early 90s. Played it a million times. And this is my DVD of Repo Man. It's 4 a.m. Do you know where your car is? And yeah, Emilio Estevez, Harry Dean Stanton, directed by Alex Cox, executive producer Michael Nesmith. Anyway, if you've never seen this movie, this is it's a pretty crazy punk rock sci-fi comic book come to life. This is my Criterion Blu-ray of Repo Man. I don't even have a Blu-ray player yet because I'm always one technology behind. But this has some extras that I needed. It has like the made for TV edit where they added some extra scenes, some more scenes of the Chevy Malibu guy talking to fill in space because they had to cut out a lot of the language. Anyway, so here's the soundtrack album. This is the soundtrack album. This is like a US press of the soundtrack album. I had two. I used to have a UK press of the soundtrack album with a different label also. But this is the US press of the soundtrack album with the custom label on San Andreas Records. And a few other kind of related records. Okay, so in the soundtrack is TV Party by Black Flag, and it's the single version, which is different from the album version of TV Party on Black Flag's Damaged album. Suicidal Tendencies Institutionalized is also on the soundtrack album, and there's their whole album. Let's Have a War by Fear. What's weird is on the Repo Man soundtrack album, it has this kind of intro that is not on the album version. This is not an original, because the original has a silver label that I think has a custom printed inner sleeve, but this is a later pressing of it. Of course, any old punk record is gold, and there'll be people trying to extract as much cash from you as possible. But, you know, you see old punk records, grab them for that reason. This is a kind of cheesy CD compilation called Punk University. And I picked this up because this has the original full band version of When the Shit Hits the Fan by the Circle Jerks, which in the soundtrack, of course, the Circle Jerks perform an acoustic version of it. And last but not least, this is the Untouchables Dance Party. And they were a groovy, funky kind of band, but they don't have any songs on the soundtrack, but they appear in the movie. I'm not going to spoil. I'm not going to spoil it, but yeah, they have an acting part in the movie. But anyway, that's my movie tip. If you have not seen Repo Man, also because they're talking about, the director's talking about making a sequel, which I'm kind of apprehensive about that, but this is a fun movie. If you haven't seen it, do check it out. Anyway, peace. I'll tell you where. Okay then, that's my video. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, leave a comment, and peace.